In the last video, we have covered how we can add a plugin to the rich text editor. In this video, I'm going to cover how we can configure and use blocks. Blocks are used to nest the content for an easier overview and structure of the content when edited or created. From Umbraco 13, it is possible to configure blocks in rich text editor, just like the block editors. So let's go back to our rich text editor configuration. And then here we will need first to enable block. Then under available blocks, we can define a new one. When we click on add, we will need to create a new element type. So let's create a new element type and we call this my block. Then we add a new property and call this one block title with the editor of text box. Then we add one more property and call this one block body. And here we add a rich text editor with a new configuration. Submit, save and close. Now we have the option to configure the new element type block, where we can add a label, which in this case we will add the block title, so that whenever we add a title, then that's how it will show on the block. We can also toggle it so that it displays in line with the text. We can add some custom view, some custom style sheet. We can choose the editor size overlay. And then by default, the content model will be the one that we have just configured. Then we can add some more settings model, and then we can choose the appearance of the block. Let's say, for example, we choose this color, and then for the icon color, we choose this one. We can also add some thumbnails and we can hide the content editor. I'll just go ahead, submit and save. And now if we go back to the content, let's say we remove a little bit of the content and then we insert a block. Here we can add a block title and we can call this first block, and here content from the block create, and now we can see that we have our first block. Now we can save and publish. However, if we go back to the front end, we get an error. The reason for this is that in order to render the blocks in the rich text editor, we need to create partial views for each block. And it is expected to be in a folder called rich text components, and then using the name of the element type that has been created for the block. So let's go ahead and do this. So we go back to settings, then we go to partial views. We create a new folder and call this rich text. Then inside the rich text folder, we create a new folder called components. And inside components, we create a new empty partial view and we call this my block. Which is the same name of our element type. Now we will need to add the following model so that we have access to the properties of the content and settings model of our block. So now we are able to render our block title and block body with the following. I just gave it an h tag to the block title, and the block body does not need any paragraphs or headings as it already has paragraph tags built in. So let's go ahead and save. And now if we refresh our frontend, we can see that we have the content from our blog. In this video, we have learned how we can create and use blogs in Rich Text Editor. In the next video, I will cover how we can configure our own style formats. Stay tuned for the next video.